Hi, guys.
Hey.
You ready? How are you, Katie?
Today is speech therapy day.
You look pretty in pink today.
Just one in a steady stream of appointments for 24-year-old Katie Stubblefield. Each day and every day, a different doctor or specialist. But on this day, she gets to do one of her favorite things, sing.
Good.
Soft yet confident, Katie sings from the heart. Her voice a reminder of how far she's come since we last saw her nearly 2 years ago.
Good, make that sure that chin's down. Good.
As the youngest recipient of a face transplant in the United States, Katie has been through a lot, both medically and emotionally. At just 18 years old, Katie survived a suicide attempt. And while her injuries were severe, she miraculously pulled through. Her speech and her appearance have improved dramatically.
There was some significant operations to work on her jaw, as well as her eyes, I should add. But in terms of her jaw, the big issue was the trauma went underneath her tongue, and the top of her tongue, albeit looking normal, is sitting on basically, instead of a bunch of muscle, which would move the tongue around and allow you to swallow and articulate, it's really just scar tissue.
So now you're gonna say, hi.
Hi.
That's what we're dealing with.
Dr. Brian Gassman is Katie's plastic surgeon at the Cleveland Clinic and a member of Katie's transplant team. He was part of a team of 11 Cleveland Clinic surgeons to perform the hospital's third face transplant.
I was definitely doting on her.
Dr. Gassman, seeing in Katie his own daughter.
I saw her as a young woman my daughter's age, and there was definitely a lot of empathy from me to her naturally because of what she was going through, and I felt almost like an overwhelming force to try to get her better.
Do you like this Ohio weather? Is it okay, or is it too cold?
And each day is better than the last. Where she started and where she is now, remarkable, according to her doctors.
Shockingly, and she may be the only patient in the United States, if not internationally, has never had a rejection episode. Which is amazing.
All right, did you bring the oral stretch?
Her speech therapist at Lake West Medical Center playing a large role in her recovery as well.
When I met Katie, she really had a lot of trouble opening her mouth. And what I did is I assessed all the muscles. You want to put it in yourself?
I trust
you. You trust me? I got her an oral stretch device, which basically opens the mouth. You insert it into the mouth and you squeeze it, and it increases the range of motion of the jaw muscles.
And the device has helped a lot. When Katie started, her jaw function was considered severe. Now it's mild.
And she's motivated. You know, she does what she's supposed to do. She comes to all her therapy sessions, you know, constantly asking, you know, how was I? Did I do better? How can I get better?
Good.
From their home in Oxford, Mississippi, to the Ronald McDonald House in Cleveland, to now their own apartment in Little Italy, the Stubblefields are finding their new normal in Northeast Ohio.
How has it been for you? Do you think that this experience has changed you at all?
Oh my gosh, we're not the same people. There's no way possible. It changes you. You say, well, I just want to get back to living life. There is no getting back. And it's not that life is ruined as much as it just, your perspective has changed. Your approach has changed everything.
Katie's dad says her recovery is a marathon and there are no days off.
The whole thing has been progress. Sometimes you'd like it to happen faster. Sometimes it's four steps forward, two backwards.
So where do you get your strength from?
Between our faith, recognizing we still have our daughter and that there is a future that most obviously she has nowhere near plateaued.
She is just genuinely, and it's so apparent, she's just genuinely happy to be alive.
Oh my gosh, yes. It's just, she is so thankful.
The hardest part for Katie's mom has been dealing with the guilt, often blaming herself for what happened that day, now 6 years ago.
Now my doctors and my family tells me, Elisa, this is not your fault, it's not your fault, Katie got hurt. But as a mom, it's just hard to think that, you know, that she didn't come to me that moment.
But having Katie still here with them is something both mom and dad are so thankful for.
To hear her sing again and her witty jokes, it just, my heart you know, because she's come, not that she hasn't been here, but she's had a lot of pain in this journey, but her will to fight, I don't know if I could do it.
As for Katie, she doesn't remember what happened the day she was hurt. She sometimes will ask her parents about it, but she doesn't dwell in the past. Instead, she looks to the future.
Physically, I'm feeling much better. Also, with a speech therapy and so many other therapies, things are progressing very well.
But every day isn't easy.
Initially, I'm freaking crazy. I know I had my good sometimes, but really, I still feel very positive and just grateful that I was able to have my transplant and that it's given me a new opportunity at life.
Being alive, something Katie says she thinks about all the time.
Every morning I wake up, I'm happy and thankful that I'm here today and that I have today. I'm thankful for life.
A life she says she's learned is worth living, a valuable lesson she hopes to share with others.
Awesome. High five. Awesome. Resonating.